Today's software testing day. SDK. So this won't work yet. But that won't work, it's already defined, yeah. So yeah, I'm installing Fedora 20. Because that's oh, it's early. I don't think I got my 8 hours. So that's procedure that I need to follow to basically just test the integration of the whole SIL stuff into the current infrastructure. So it's basically just doing the normal stuff, I suppose, the stuff that I do almost every day, I guess. But then on a system that is using a customized tool chain. And then just play around with it a little bit. And then find bugs. I feel I owe that to the community. Personally, I can't wait to get rid of tools like SE-Manage, SE-Module. But oh well. It's done installing. Now, first thing I'll do is update the system. That might be a good idea. That's wrong. What was it? Ugh, damn. Yeah, ABC 123. Shit. Okay, so. Need to keep that in mind. Usually I use ABC123 and the so early that I did a typo that I didn't notice. It's ABC 123. So I wasn't able to log in. Authentication issue. So yeah, first I'll just get the spectators up to date. Just get that out of the way. And then I'll start by following the procedure. And then I suppose I should also get the SACLC compiler on here later on. See if it really integrates, I suppose, basically by, I'm not sure, that's speculation, how that's going to work or not work. But like I said, if it were up to me, we would just drop SEManage, SEModule, a lot of these tools. Because in my view, they really don't make anything easier. They just add new commands. New programs, other ways of doing it, maybe seemingly easier ways of doing it, but extra, it's just all extra, extra, extra. And I'm basically for the idea that keep it minimal, keep it, but keep it comprehensive. And keep it small. I'd like to basically do the scripting myself, I suppose. If something needs to be scripted, because most of the time you really don't need it. Except like, for example, stuff like genhome.com. But like stuff like setting a boolean, it's just as easy as echoing a 1 and a 0 to sysfs se linux, what is it? Oh, we're already getting invalid contacts. So there's something not quite right there. Or there was something not quite right there, I'm not sure what, which one of it is. But yeah, with SACLC, basically, there's really no need. You can just, if you have the source files installed on the system, then you can just go ahead and edit them, then compile the modified sources and just load them up. That's the idea. Alright, so we're having an up-to-date system. Do we have to boot? Is there a kernel? Should be kernel in there. Don't see any kernel, but it might be. We do have systemd libs. Anyways, we'll probably need to boot later. So the procedure is start with a fresh Fedora X minimal installation. I have that. Install these crappers. Then all. Damn. Yeah, well, so this is console, so the screen is could be a little bit corrupted. That sucks with console. Maybe I should just log in to SSH just to make sure. See? Yep. Screen is corrupted. Either that's because of the serial console or because of my 4K screen. Both have some. Weird thingies. Okay. Update to the latest target policy. I think I already did that. Clone the repositories. Oh, it's SIL already. Create a SIL link to the SIL repo so SIL can be built into libsepol. Now this needs to be done in a different way. Let's just SSH into the system first because IP address show. Not this one, this one. And we have an IP address of 228. Oh shit. I need to have my GPT key. Oh, or my SSH key. For authentication, my crypto stick. So I'm plugging in my crypto stick and let's just authenticate. Yeah. Okay. So. Oh, right. This was right. Always get confused. Yeah. I always get confused with siblings, what one is the source and what one is the target. It's not just the case with siblings, also with Tar. Okay, install user space. So, where should I be going? I suppose I should be in SE Linux here. I'm not sure. I'm just going to do it the way he asked me to do it. But this probably won't work. It actually will. It does work. And that seems to be okie dokie, I suppose. Migrate to the new source. So we're moving from etc as Linux to varlib as Linux. And it's the okay. So might be an idea to just I don't know how this works. Might be an idea to just reboot. See if the policy from varlib as Linux is loaded by default. whether this shit loads up even. If it does, I'm impressed already. But yeah, it's, I suppose it does. So let's just run some tools. I should probably use the cManage stuff. So I'm supposing that this is all the stuff. So what's the stuff that you would normally do? Normally I would probably toggle a boolean on and off. So like, for example, sysadmin exec content. I don't know this syntax. Shit. Okay. Jesus Christ. I'm like, so we had this set a cbool tool. And well, let's just get a set a cbool and then either persistent up persist and then bool name and then on and off. And now we have a new command because we wanted everything in cManage. And I do like the idea of centralizing stuff from an admin perspective, I suppose, if you use these tools anyways. But now you have another command to learn or another syntax. Okay, let's see if this actually applied. Sysadmin exec content, where are you? Somewhere here. Suppose we should scrap. And it's set to off. settle off. So far so good. So let's have a look at. Now this seems like. Everything is kept basically intact, I suppose. And this is where the new store is. And here we have the new modules. So let's have a look at the module. A simple one. Well, there's no simple ones. RT kit. Oh, these are actually directories. Can we clear this? Yeah, we can. See it still. God damn it. I hate that. It's this terminal shit, the serial terminal shit. Ah, it's been binary. A binary. The fuck? That's something I don't understand. That is something I don't understand. For Christ's sakes. So let's disable a module. one insignificant one, because as far as I'm concerned, there's bugs in the disabled modules stuff. Let's list the modules. That's module L. Let's remove the IRC module, but before we do, let's just confirm that there is an IRC. This is search ASIRCT. Yeah, install IRC tools console. That part also works. The part where RPM is still running without, yeah, with the proper policy. Okay, so ASCII tools of ASCII search allow source IRCT. So it returns a bunch of rules, as the info, obviously, IRCT returns. So let's just, oh, those are actually aligned, yeah, right. So let's just ASCII module disable IRC. And we got a bunch of contexts getting becoming invalid. Not sure why this why it's spitting that to the screen. Those contexts aren't actually used, or yeah, there's no objects labeled with those contacts, but whatever. Alright, so supposedly it's disabled now. Let's have a look at that disabled module. And there we have the IRC module. Let's see if the types are also really gone. And it's gone. So that, so far that, that seems to work. Yeah, that seems to work. Let's just reboot. Probably not really needed, but do it anyways. Let's see if it's still the same. Let's do an ASCII module list grep IRC. And it doesn't list it. Now, normally it would have listed it with disabled behind it, but that's not the case. But if I do an ASCII info T IRCT, not return, and it doesn't return. So it is disabled, but it's just not in the list as usual. So that's something that is not quite the same as it was. It's just removed, so that might be confusing, because you can also remove it, and then it's really gone from the list. So that might be something to look at. All right, so let's just re-enable it. As a module, enable IRC. What am I doing? Oh, not T. E. And I do and the tights are back in place. Now, as you might do this again. And it's back. Alright. Now, let's just, for the sake of testing, create a new module. So let's just, or actually let's just first add a port and delete a port as you manage port add type SSH. Well, let's just use HTTP port and then protocol TCP and then port is 7. Let's just delete that port. Do a port com to confirm. Well, let's just do first this one here. And it returns empty and then the port com. And it's gone. So that works as well. What other options do we have? Well, let's get to the user related options later. Let's just load a simple module. Nano my tests T policy module my tests wonderful. And let's just declare a type. Basically, all. Okay, so that probably means that I need to install yum install as a Linux policy devel. Not sure, but. Oh, holy shit. This is where things seem to go sour. Fuck. Okay, then fuck that shit. Let's just do that another way. Nano my test T. And let's just do it the old-fashioned way. Module my test 1.0. And then just require attribute files type. And then type attribute. My test to files type. And then mount check module, because I'm not really very comfortable with that stuff. Let's copy this over. My test. And we have a PPT here, if all is well, at least a mod. Let's just build that man as a module package, or package it. And let's copy this one here. And paste that, and then just my test it. And then test. So let's just as a module install my test PP. Barring any typos, it should, I guess, work. And we have an error. Filter reserve resolve type attribute set. And but that is a bug, I suppose. That seems to be a bug. And it seems to be related to this not being, nah, that can't be. It's just not. The file type does exist, doesn't it? Oh, actually, no, it doesn't. I'm stupid. It's file type. I'm always getting confused with the interface and the actual attribute. So yeah, let's do that again. My fault, my mistake. Okay, so SE info T my test. And it's there. LS all Z Firelight SE Linux targeted active modules. Here we have 400. So these are probably modified. Yeah. SE module list. Grab my test. And it's listing that. Nice. SE module. Bunch of modules, and I see they remove the base modules, so that's all. Oh no, that's the base module, so it's not quite. But they removed, I think, a lot of stuff, so that it looks natural. But yeah, the base module should probably be removed from this list because it's not removable. And that's my test module. So to avoid problems, you might want to remove that from the list if possible. So yeah, this looks great. Okay, so that works. What else do we have? Well, the basic stuff like adding a user. So if I basically add user John. And then the way as you manage login a start view with R and 0 is C103 and it's done. So the messages are informative. As he mentioned, has improved. But it's still Python. Okay, so as he mentioned, login list. And John is set to stuff. How does that look? Well, I suppose exactly the same as I suppose this isn't this is just a matter of changing the path. This trivial, I suppose. Anything else? You have ports, modules, nodes, context. Okay, let's add a context. Now, this works exactly as planned. let's just remove it as well. So that works as well. This works. But what I don't understand is how we're doing this, but how can I basically write a SIL module and integrate this? How do I go about doing that? So sure, we make it easy to use SIL policy on a system, but what if I want to do it the other way around? Now I'm defaulting to basically the old policy language, but if I want to default to SIL, how would that look? And that sucks. That part is, I suppose, looks neglected. But the weird thing is that cd var lib as Linux targeted active. And let's look at this. It has only an active dir. Where are these source? Where are the sources installed? This looks so weird. The sources aren't installed. You probably need a devel version or something like that. A lot of questions. It's a bit verbose, don't you think? Huh? Holy shit. Whoops. Weird. That was a bit scary. What's that lang ext? PP extension. Yeah. So this is just binary. Just binary. And it's just binary. That's just the devel stuff. That's not gonna work. Okay, let's just try it. But it's not gonna work, I suppose. Not gonna work. I don't understand how this is supposed to work. Am I overlooking something? Am I misunderstanding anything? I think so. That's just awesome. No. But that's my fault. So I'll just open up a Eclipse. If this works, then I'm really happy about that. I'm really impressed. where's some type attribute set? Yeah. That's something. Yeah, it's the other way around, I think. It's the other way around. Awesome. Awesome. It's not there. It's in the 400 there. Yeah, and that's not gonna happen. For Christ's sakes. And let's just remove it. This is a little verbose. And I think info. Yeah, I don't know what to say. It seems to just work. Except maybe. Yeah, seems to just work. File context template, home deep template. This sucks. Yeah, so there seems to be one problem here with Jen Houndercon. Let's try that out. So I added this new user, John, and his stuff. But yeah, weird. How does that work? It works, but I don't know how it works. There's no stuff, context specs. Yeah, info. Falo com o founder. It's all Uncle Fine. Oh, I'm looking at, maybe I'm looking at the wrong shit. Let's have a look. I don't understand that. Yeah, well, this is a long list. I don't understand that. But it looks right, so it looks right. I can try it again, but it just somewhere it's properly specified. Yeah, somewhere it's properly specified. Except, why is it resetting? What's it resetting? Yeah. That's weird. Yeah, that's weird. These contacts here. Fix files. Fix files. Store. So yeah, that's one issue here. I don't know, by the way, where the home dir context for John are specified. They are specified somewhere, but they aren't in the file context home dirs. I can't find them there, so it must be somewhere else. And then yeah, it keeps resetting every time and every time. But other than that, it's just pretty damn flawless. That it even works out of the box. That they were able to just convert this policy to sale. So yeah, for now that's it, because I can't think of anything more. But so, few points. Where are the file contacts for John stored? Because they aren't in in file context hungers. So where are they? And then why is this happening? All the time. And that's it. Other than that, it just works. As far as I'm concerned, but it needs more thorough testing, of course. You need to actually run this on a live, on a day-to-day system. But the quick test, everything.